So why do we want a multiprocessor? Why not just use uniprocessors? Well, first, our uniprocessors would already be 4 wide. When we got to about 4 to 6 wide is when we switched to using multiprocessors, and that's because once you get to this point, you get diminishing returns from making the uniprocessor even wider. You can make it execute, let's say, 6 or 8 instructions per cycle, but you don't get as much from that extension as you did from, for example, making it from 2 to 4 wide. And that's because we get diminishing returns. If you remember your Amdahl's law, there will be things that benefit from this, such as programs that have a lot of parallelism between instructions. And then there are things that don't benefit from this, such as programs that have a lot of dependencies, so they have to run things one at a time. Things that are 4 wide already are already making the parallel parts fast, whereas the one at a time parts are not accelerated. So by the time you get here, you already have a lot of your program suffer from not enough parallelism to benefit from either 4 or even 6 wide. Another problem with uniprocessors, if we make them even fancier, is to make them faster, we have to jack up the frequency. To do that, we have to raise the voltage from what it would be if it used a lower frequency. And when we do both of these, the power consumption grows up cubically. So even if we increase the frequency by not too much, we would end up burning our processor. So we don't really want to make our uniprocessors be clocked twice as fast as before, and we don't want to make them much wider than they already are. But Moore's law continues. We get twice the transistors every 18 months for the same cost as before and in the same area as before. So we want to benefit from this and improve the overall performance, but we no longer can do it this way. So what do? We just double the number of cores every 18 months. That allows us to have the cores that are not getting wider, that are not getting up in frequency too much, and yet the overall computational performance of the chip is improving with Moore's law. So we can get approximately a doubling of overall performance every 18 months. That is only if we assume that we can use all the cores. If we only have one program with one thread, then we're really using only one of the cores. It doesn't matter if the number of cores doubles because we are still using one of those cores. So we need programs that are parallel in order to exploit our many core processors that we're getting. But if we do, we continue the trend of scaling performance up exponentially. To put this in another way, we have multiprocessors today, not because we think that we would rather have twice the cores than twice the uniprocessor performance. It's always preferable to have a uniprocessor, a single core that is twice as fast as before, than having two cores that are just as fast as before. But we ran out of things that we can do with uniprocessors. So after a long string of years where we were doing this, just getting better uniprocessors, we had to switch to this if we want to get performance improvement.